Some people enjoy relaxing, going out for food. You know, I personally, after the game, I like to have a beer, and I think a lot of other players do as well. I don't think there's nothing wrong with that. It's all in moderation, and same as everything, really.
Yeah. Like donuts.
Like chocolate donuts.
Baby, it's because of you that I do the things I do. Every time we touch, it means so much.
Is that a drink?
Yeah, it's protein plus to put all my muscle on top. Okay. That's what my body looks like, really, honestly.
Every time you're near, I have no fear, and it's all because of you.
I've always played the number 13 on, which is unlucky for some. But my goal is always a warning for Cardiff. And I did ask him for my jersey. But he said he's always worried for Cardiff. And so I just have to take my turn.
And you prefer to play without a number than with a 12?
Correct.
Touching the heart of me.
I think it was good passing. Lee Davis again draws him in. Excellent pass, but Hemi Taylor, so much to do.
It was a great bonus to me at that age to play, really. And so I just relaxed, went out there, enjoyed it. I had a good Five Nations. And you know, I just got to try and recreate that for this year.
Lee Davis, the man with no number on his back. Now, David, if you wanted a player like Lee Davis at Newport, how would you tempt him?
How would you tempt him? Well, the thing is this, I think what the club has to do at Newport, or any club has to do, is provide the right facilities, right atmosphere, and get the right team to go around him.
It's not the cheque. It's not the size of the cheque that's...
Well, I think that far too many players probably think that's all that really matters in the game, and I think the clubs, in fairness, have driven them that way, and professionals in general have done that.
There's an article this morning in one of the morning papers by Steve McDowell, the former All Black, that says that one of the problems in Wales is that that's all we talk about, is money in the game.
I think it's absolutely true. We didn't have any clear directions of which way professionalism was going. Every club pitched their monetary terms, and players used that as a lynch between deciding where they were going to go. And I don't think we've helped it. We thought we were having a lot of money as clubs in the game. We didn't have it, but everybody went out and spent it. And I think then moderation became ridiculous.
How are you surviving then at Newport? What are you surviving on?
Well, the thing is this, we've budgeted we'd probably lose £150,000 this year. I mean, that's a budget, and we've taken it on a basis of just having moderate players in position. It's the catch-22. Mm. If you have great players, you have to pay big money. We've decided to go in at one particular level and hope that we can produce the talent with the young players that we got and the right coaching and the right atmosphere those players to play in.
But you have made peace, the Welsh clubs have made peace with the WRU. Has that made a difference?
We've made peace with the WRU. It needs a big push from a PR point of view, and we've all carped on. We've carped as clubs, the union have carped as well, and realistically what we have to do probably is put it all behind us. And then the players have to realise that they can only get what the budget allows.
Yeah. Phil, what about the story at Llanelli? Because they've lost a major backer down there, haven't they?
Yes, apparently there was going to be £3 million put into the club, and I think the two backers have since deserted the club, if you wish to put it that way, and I think the supporters are left in no man's land. They don't know what's happening there. And of course, in the meantime, Alan, and I think David hit the nail on the head, the players have been paid huge contracts, which really the gates that all the Welsh clubs have, they just cannot afford to pay from those.
I mean, Llanelli is one of the big clubs, and they're still looking for big money to come in. What about some of the clubs in the lower reaches of the First Division, if and when, next season perhaps, the Welsh Rugby's First Division becomes 8 clubs?
Yeah, I think what they've got to do is budget, get the right people in. You see, we were amateur for well over 100 years, and then professional came round the corner. We had no guidance, no help, and really I think we've all been caught lacking, and that's not only Llanelli. I think other clubs are really going to struggle, and there could be a few clubs in a very, very perilous position at the moment.
So what do, David? You lose 150 grand, what, you go to the bank and you say...
No. We don't. We just hope that the players we have will produce the sort of rugby that will bring crowds back to Rodney Parade. That's one of the reasons. The other thing is this, that we have to be realistic and go forward. We have to produce and provide facilities which are better than any other club has. And we have to have investors to believe in us to do just that. And if we can do that, perhaps that's what we will be able to do.
But bricks and mortar and building new stands and facilities, I mean, that, again, just increases the load on the club.
But what has Welsh Rugby realistically done in 20 years? They've provided no schools of excellence. They've done nothing really for kids to really come into the game. We've lost so many people out. For the first time ever, we're advertising for tickets for international matches, and that really shows the general demise of the attraction of playing rugby football. And I would have thought, with the schoolboys going comprehensive, that we would have really have fulfilled an obligation to Welsh people, that is, if it is a national sport, we go to the valleys, we provide entertainment, we provide centres of excellence, and we have people who want to play rugby because it's the game to play. Mm. It's the old thing. Rugby League have done it by producing good games on television. All of a sudden, we are selling their shirts in South Wales. Mm-hmm. And I would have thought now is the time that we should put our house in order and sell our Welsh shirts because we're producing that brand of rugby that the 70s provided us with. And we sell our shirts everywhere else. So the game becomes a national. It's a joke to say it's a national game. Mm. At the moment, it's struggling on a par with what four or five other sports.
Yeah, and you should be worried, I suppose, if and when the European rugby becomes the focus, the main focus, and Newport briefly, Dave, are going to be left behind if they don't catch up.
That's right. But I would have thought that if we'd put thoughts properly about it, give 20,000 for a player to play an international match, and the pyramid goal goes up to everybody who wants to play for £20,000. Mm. Cap and a jersey no longer. That's part of it, but £20,000. That way, we wouldn't have had tangents of people breaking off to get bigger money in lesser places.
Thank you. Thanks very much. What do you do when you're on the wrong side of 35? Well, give it.